वेलकम स्टूडेंट, वेलकम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक अनदर प्रैक्टिकल ऑन थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ अ मेटल रॉड। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी व्हाट इज द एम ऑफ दिस प्रैक्टिकल। द एम इज डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ द मेटल रॉड थ्रू दिस एपरेटस। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट आर द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ दिस एपरेटस वी विल सी इन डिटेल। सो दिस इज द होल्डिंग टैंक वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू पुट द वाटर इनसाइड ऑफ द टैंक। एंड आफ्टर दैट दीज आर द वाटर असेंबली पाइप्स एंड सम फ्लो डाइवर्जन वॉल्स टू रेगुलेट एंड टू स्टॉप द फ्लो ऑफ द वॉटर। आफ्टर दैट दिस इज द केसिंग फॉर द मेटल रॉड। दिस इज द मेटल केसिंग, सिलेंड्रिकल मेटल केसिंग फॉर द हाउसिंग ऑफ द मेटल रॉड। इन साइड वॉट द ऑलमोस्ट 7 सेंटीमीटर डायमीटर ऑफ द मेटल रॉड इज गोइंग टू फिटेड इन साइड। The length of the metal rod is from this point to this point. There are 5 types of thermocouples from T1 to T5, which is attached at the various point inside of the metal rod. You can come. After that, this is the control panel of the entire assembly. In that control panel, we will get 3 types of readings: voltage, current, and temperature readings. And all after all getting that reading, we are going to get the calculations for calculating thermal conductivity, that is K value. So first of all, this is the indicator of the heating load. This is the heating load called as the heating load, which can show that your load is going to on. And if your load is on, initial readings, you can set the initial reading 0 like that. You see that here now there is no voltage and no current is there. This is called as a variac, or this is called as a controller also. Change the reading of voltage simultaneously current also. If I have increased the voltage reading here, so ultimately what will happen? Heating of this metal rod will take place. We have to put the water here. Why? Once we will circulate the water surrounding of the cylinder, we will get uniform increase in the temperature. There will be not sudden increasing, because water is going to maintain the temperature distribution. So water is there to circulate surrounding of the cylinder. Okay, after that you will see once the you see that 79 voltage 80 volt is there. At that 80 volt there is no current is there. There it will be a current 0.01 ampere, but you see that now okay, so this is the value of voltage. Now you see the value of current is there in ampere, 0.03. sometimes it is, yes, it is going to be stable after some period of time. Okay, now I am going to explain you how the calculations are going to carried out. So simply, according to Fourier's law, Q is equal to Ka dT by dx is the formula. Okay, so where A is the area of the metal rod. Since the area, the metal rod is cylindrical, we are going to use 2 pi r l, where r is the radius of the metal rod and l is the length of the metal rod. Once we put here, now what is the Q value? Q will be the product of A into B, that is value of A into value of B, you will get the value of Q. After that dT is the temperature difference. Now I will explain. This is the indicator where T1 is the temperature at the starting point, which could be very maximum. I will increase the voltage supply. You see that suddenly temperature is also going to increase. 34 is now the T1 temperature here. If we want to take the temperature difference T1 and T3 for example, then what will happen? We have to take the T1 temperature here, T2 and T3. You see T1 is 35, T1 temperature is 35 and T3 temperature is 32. Now this difference is called as the delta T. Delta X is the radius, that thickness of the metal rod you can take, or radius of the metal rod. Ultimately Q we have known, that A we can calculate, dT we have to calculate from here, temperature of the, you see T1, T2, T3 and T4. These all 5 readings are of the metal rod only. You can take any one difference from that. So you get the reading of delta T, temperature difference, from this dial pad, this indicator. Dx we can calculate,
then area we can calculate. Only one unknown is there, K. So K is equal to Q upon A dx upon dt. So this is the simple formula to get the thermal conductivity of the metal rod.
I hope you understand this, the simple practical. This variac used for varying the temperature and varying the voltage and ampere reading. What will happen? Suppose we have kept it for 175. Now until the temperature of T1 is become stagnant, steady state, we cannot take that finalized temperature. Once the temperature is going to be steady, then that is going to put in the formula. So that is called as a steady state temperature. जब तक ये टेम्परेचर स्टडी नहीं होता तब तक हम फॉर्मूले में इस वैल्यू को नहीं डाल सकते. तो यहाँ पे हमें थोड़ी देर के लिए रुकना होता है कि 174 वोल्टेज पे टेम्परेचर कहाँ रुकने वाला है. तो वैसे जैसे भी हमें T1 पता चल जाता है, हम T3 ले लेंगे, तो ये दोनों डिफरेंस में हमें हीट ट्रांसफर का रेट समझ जाएगा और उसके ऊपर हम थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी कैलकुलेट कर सकते हैं. थैंक यू गाइज, थैंक यू. एंड द एंटायर प्रैक्टिकल ऑन डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ द मेटल रॉड. थैंक यू.